Hello, my name is Andrew Schomburg, and I'd like to talk to you about PathoBox to tell you how to put it on a microscope. PathoBox is a system of 3D printed parts that accommodate a variety of imaging devices on your microscope eyepiece. These imaging devices can be a smartphone, a camera, or an iPad. This allows you to take pictures and videos in order to share with colleagues to discuss. How do you put these imaging devices on your eyepiece, you might ask? If you have a rubber guard on your eyepiece, at first, do remove that. Second, if you have an adjustable binocular eyepiece, and preferably you do bring those binoculars as close as possible together. This best accommodates an easy fit of the 3D printed box that is the fundamental mounting device for this system. You want it to fit easily on your eyepiece. Once it's fit on, you want to bring those binoculars far apart as they can be within the box in order to secure a fit, a snug fit. You don't want this box moving from side to side or pitching forward because that would put your phone or your camera at risk of falling to the ground. Next, you'll assemble a system of parts that best accommodates your imaging device, such as a smartphone, to align with the light that comes from your eyepiece. I'll give you a number of parts that allows you to universally, in a sense, put these imaging devices on your eyepiece. I'd like to focus on briefly these locking parts that fit most snugly into the table, and the large bumpers, which are multi-purpose, as well as the guards. What I like to do, especially at first when I'm learning to use a particular camera or a particular smartphone at perhaps a new eyepiece, is I use this sandwich approach, where I have a bumper in front of the camera to control how closely the camera is to the eyepiece, and that's important to get the best picture. If your picture is too small or too large, you want to adjust which bumper you use, a thick one, a thin one, for instance. And then your other bumper, or one of your other bumpers, can be placed on the other side. Finally, there's this small locking part that fits in snugly to tie everything together. So in effect, you have a camera sandwich. On the sides, guards. I've only shown one yellow guard here, but guards on each side are important, especially at first when we're learning about how to use the system and it's most at risk of tipping over. Have those guards on the side to prevent the camera from sliding off laterally. Please give us your comments at Pathopathology. Apply to us. We want to know how to make this system better.